What's going on, guys? Welcome to another video. Today we're going to be talking about whether or not you should get a master's degree in engineering. Now, in this video, I'm not going to tell you what to do, but all I'm doing is I'm going to give you another perspective that you should consider when making a decision. Now, in my opinion, in my perspective, I've been on the field for about 7 years now. I'm a mechanical engineer. I did not get my master's degree, but I have worked with people that have their master's degree, and when making such a decision, there's a lot of things that come into play, you know, because not everybody's obviously on the same boat. A lot of people have the time and money and they just go ahead and get it over with. They get their master's degree or even PhD. That's good for them. They already know exactly what they want to do. They want to do some type of research. They want to be experts at one thing and one thing only. If that's you and you want to get that done, that's your goal, then that's great. You really don't need to watch this video. But this video is gonna be for the people that are a little insecure whether or not they should take out more loans, or they should go out and work in the industry and get a little bit of experience before they actually make such decision. Anyway, so let's talk about one side of the first side of the fence I'm gonna be talking about is the people that have the time, money, and know exactly what to do. What I would do is get a master's degree in some type of management. An MBA is very common. A lot of people do that in the engineering world, unless you know exactly what you want to do and you want to specialize in one thing only, like something very technical. If that's you, if you want to specialize in something very technical, then go ahead and I would do an engineering master's degree. Otherwise, if you're not sure, if you want to get a master's just for the sake of getting a master's, I would just go with an MBA or something that's management or systems engineering. It's another very common one. Because I'm saying this because those master's degrees are going to help you be more versatile and more general. So that's that. Now, on the other side of the fence, we have the people like myself who were a little insecure, who were a little, not insecure in terms of low confidence, but a little bit unsure about what to do, whether they should go out and work or whether they should stay in school, take out loans and live off their loans to keep working towards their master's degree just because they think they need a master's degree. Now, there are two options, right? Two perspectives. Do you need a master's degree? It depends on what you want to do. If you want to get a high ranking position, a leadership position, one of those where you're a manager or a senior executive or a CEO, then I would want to say that is getting a master's would set you up very, very well to being qualified and eligible to get such positions. And the other perspective is, okay, well, do you really, or you just want to get a master's because you just want to get a master's on your title? Well, if that's the case, if you just want to get a master's just because you want the title, I would ask myself what you really want to do. In that case, I would technically go out and go work first. I would go out and work and get a feel for the work, you know, get a feel for your job, the industry, and then make a decision, make an informed and more educated decision down the road in a year or two. That's actually gonna also clear your vision as to whether or not you want to get a master's in a technical field or get a master's degree in a more management field. So it really comes down to what you actually want to do long term. In summary, if you want to get a high position, if you wanna climb up the corporate ladder, then by all means, I would get a master's degree and get it out of the way. But hear me out, then the question comes, okay, who's gonna pay for it, right? Because a lot of times we have the time when we are graduating college, we are 21, between 21 and 23 years old, and perhaps we have the time, but then we don't have the money. I really, really encourage you to look for other people or companies to look for sponsorships, to look for someone else to pay for your master's degree. I really think there is no need for you to go and pay for your master's degree because there are many opportunities. If you're in college, I would become a research assistant or a teacher's assistant. Colleges themselves have a lot of positions to help postgraduate students and get them free education. Who knows, maybe sometimes you even get a stipend. So you get paid to go to school, basically. I mean, obviously you're gonna have to put in some work. But going back to having somebody else pay for your master's degree, once you go out and experience the world a little bit and get a little bit of a better feel about what you want to do. You can go to companies, and there are companies, a lot of the companies and most companies that I've dealt with, small and big companies, they offer you some type of reimbursement program. Now, it's not going to be, they're not going to reimburse you for a full-time program where you're going to be, where you're going to be finished with your master's in 2 years. But they perhaps it's going to take you a little longer, and they're only going to reimburse you up to a certain amount of money per semester. In my experience, usually they reimburse you up to $5,000 or $10,000 a year. That's like 2 or 4 classes, if that, depending on the school that you go to. So basically it's going to take you a little longer to finish your master's degree, unless you also want to put some money on your own. Then in that case, obviously you're going to finish a little more quickly, but you're gonna end up paying money. It's not gonna be free. I mean, these are just some options. I mean, I encourage you to look into it. If you are thinking, if you're considering getting a master's, if you had the time and money, I would just get it over with. If you have the time but don't have the money, I would highly encourage you to look for other people to pay for your master's, or go out and work for a couple of months, for a couple of years, and then have the company that you're working for, or then find another company that's gonna help you pay for your master's degree. All right, that's the video that I wanted to make. If you like this video, if you found it valuable, insightful, or helpful in any way, please give it a thumbs up. If you are from Wisconsin, or if you've been to this university, comment below, like the video, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.